Zinc. So this is the time of year everyone asks me, should I be on zinc? Is it immune boosting?
The last thing you want to do is get sick. You know what that looks like.
Does it help with the viruses, with the flu, with pathogens, we'll say? And it's in a lot of common cold and flu formulas. Now, you know, I like black garlic and it's been studied for immune boosting, but what about zinc? It's all those over-the-counter packages, the teas, everything you can put in there. There is, however, some research that suggests taking zinc in higher doses than this in supplement form, so from supplements, not food, that's where the research came from, offer protection against these colds, flus, and viruses. And likely you haven't thought about zinc or zinc deficiency like you do vitamin D that's always in your face and in the news and in your supplements, because the body doesn't require much zinc at all, and most people are actually able to acquire enough through their food and diet. I'll talk a little bit about how you can boost it today and how much you actually get in food versus your supplement. Of course, it's almost in every multivitamin too. So if you're getting one of those, look at the dose you're getting in your multivitamin. There is, however, some research that suggests taking zinc in higher doses than this in supplement form, so from supplements, not food, that's where the research came from, may offer protection against these colds, flus, and viruses. So it does exist. The recommended dietary allowance for adult women is 8 milligrams per day. For men, it's 11 milligrams. That's according to the NIH, the National Institutes of Health. To this end, a May 2017 meta-analysis published in the JRSM found that 75 milligrams of zinc per day shortened the common cold by 33%. That's significant. That amount can come from zinc-rich foods. What would they be? Oysters. I personally love oysters. Many of you eat red meat. Make sure it's real food. Crab, lobster, and the aforementioned supplements. Most of the evidence involves consuming zinc at a much higher dose than you could realistically expect from getting from any food. Unless you're downing those oyster plates every day, and it would take 6 to 12, it would be very difficult to get more than 40 milligrams per day. Always choose real foods over supplements when possible. It's just not possible much of the time to get those kind of doses. And it's right up there with vitamin C when you find it in popular cold remedies. You see, your immune cells actually depend on zinc for healthy development and function. This is the role that zinc plays in immune functioning, and it's why researchers suspect that boosting your natural zinc intake when you're sick or just before getting sick, better yet, so the minute you think you're getting sick, that's when you should take it, but it may help shorten the duration of the illness or even stop you from getting sick at all. Another meta-analysis, this was in 2017 also, in open form infectious disease, found those who took 80 to 92 milligrams, so quite a whopping dose per day to treat their cold, they recovered 3 times faster than those who did not take it. From that study, the researchers recommended that people take zinc acetate lozenges within 24 hours of experiencing symptoms. Now, it's a little too soon to say definitively whether it will help with the new quote unquote virus, but there was a review article done in 2020 in the Frontiers in Immunology, and they proposed that the high dose at the beginning of onset and in those at high risk may be worthwhile. The NIH recommends 40 milligrams per day as the tolerable upper limit people should stick to. So definitely you want to check with your doctor on this and think about those other medications I aforementioned if you're going to these somewhat what I call super high doses. Now, for me, I like black garlic, black fermented garlic, and I like organic. I actually have that in my store. You can actually make it at home. You can ferment your regular garlic. It can take 90 days to 120 days, which is what we do with ours. And mine comes from a USA sourced organic farm. So if you're going to do it at home, use organic garlic and you can ferment it. You got to start kind of in July and August to get it ready for the fall. There is no actual data on combining zinc and garlic that I could find, but it is what I choose to do. I take garlic every day, morning and night, and then if I feel something coming on, then I'll add zinc to it. You're now gonna wanna watch this video on black garlic and the immune boosting benefits. Stay tuned here, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.